In this video, we're going to be determining or looking at the completing a metal plus a non-metal combination reaction, also sometimes called a synthesis reaction. You can also do these with a non-metal and a non-metal. Those are a little bit tougher, though, to predict what the products are going to be. But it's actually very easy to predict the products in a metal plus a non-metal because the product is always going to be an ionic compound. And we can figure out what those charges are going to be from their location in the periodic table. So let's go ahead and do this this first one here. This is the reaction between sodium and elemental chlorine. Chlorine's a diatomic gas. That's why I've got the two in there. And so this typically is what you're going to start with. And again, it's our job to figure out what the product is going to be from this reaction. So from the first one, what you want to do is start by writing just one atom of each. I'm going to do it kind of over on the right-hand side here. So I need one sodium from this. And again, I'm just going to bring one chlorine over from the the reactant side first. Even though there's a two there, that two is only because this is diatomic. It's not necessarily how many chlorine atoms you're going to have on the product side in the formula. We'll balance the whole equation a little bit later. So the next thing we need to do is figure out what the charge is on each of these. We need to balance out that charge. And just like you learned earlier then, we can use the periodic table to figure out what those charges are. Here's sodium over in the first column in the periodic table. It's going to have a plus one charge. And here's chlorine over in that second to last column in the periodic table. It's going to have a negative one charge. So we can just write those in here, plus one there and a negative one there. Since they have the same positive and negative charge, we don't need to do anything else. We just need one atom of each of those. So the chemical formula there is just going to be NaCl. That's all we need there. We don't run any other charge with that because the positive and negative are canceling each other out or equalizing each other. Once you've got your product formula in, now you can balance the equation. And so we can go back and look at the sodium. I've got one sodium here, one sodium there. So far, that's balanced. I have two chlorine atoms here, but only one chlorine atom on this side. So to balance that part of it, remember, we can only put in coefficients now in the balanced equation. So I'll put a 2 out in front of the NaCl. That just messed up my sodium. Now I have two sodiums there, so I need to put a 2 over here on the reactant side now to complete balancing that equation. All right, so that one, first one is done. We're not going to worry about predicting the phases of those at this point. We just want to complete the reaction and balance it. Let's try the next one here. This has got aluminum and sulfur. Sulfur is an 8-atom molecule, so that's why it's got an S8 there. It just means there's 8 atoms in that sulfur molecule. The metals, typically, you're just going to have one atom of each of those. So again, off to the side here, let's write down one atom of each of our elements that we're going to combine. One aluminum, one sulfur. And again, we'll go back to the periodic table to figure out what those charges are. Here's aluminum. It's in column 3A, or sometimes we call this column 13. And all the elements there are going to have typically a plus 3 charge then in that column. And compare that to sulfur. Sulfur is right here in this column. Same column as oxygen. It goes 0 for the noble gases, negative 1 for fluorine's column, negative 2 for oxygen's column. So there's sulfur right there with a negative 2. And so we sometimes write that as a 2 minus in there and a 3 plus. You can also write it plus 3 and a minus 2 in there. All right, in that case, those charges are not balanced. And so what we need to do there, there's two ways we can do this. You can kind of work your way back and forth. The shortcut way on this, which most of the time will work for you, is what I call the crisscross. I'm just going to take the charge here on the aluminum, and that tells me how many sulfurs I need. I'm going to take the charge on the sulfur, and that tells me how many aluminum atoms I need. It doesn't always work. There are some tricks to that one, but most of the time that'll work for you if you've got different charges. If the charges are the same, like we had with sodium and chlorine, then you just need one atom of each. So my formula then, it's two aluminums and three sulfurs then, Al2S3. That's our product formula. The positive and negative charges, I get a plus 6 total from the two aluminums and a negative 6 total from the three sulfurs here. When I take 3 times 2 and 2 times 3, it gives me a plus 6 and a minus 6. Now we can balance this out. I could start with the aluminum. I need two aluminums here to match the two aluminums there, but the sulfur is going to take a little bit more work. So I'm actually going to start with the sulfur here. I've got 8 sulfurs here and 3 here. And so I need to bring those both up to the same number. And the same number, the common kind of denominator, if you will, for each of those then is going to be 24. So I'm going to bring each of these sulfur amounts up to 24 atoms. And so I can do that with putting a 3 out in front of the S8 there. 8 times 3 is 24. And then to get 24 sulfurs here, I'm going to put an 8 out in front of that 8 times 3 is 24 sulfurs on that side. Now we can balance the aluminum. I've got 16 aluminum atoms here. 8 times 2 gives me 16. And so to balance that out, all I've got to do is put a 16 out in front of the aluminum. And that equation's balanced. All right, let's try this last one then. We've got potassium and phosphorus. Again, phosphorus here is 4 phosphorus atoms all stuck together in a funky little molecule there. And so let's go ahead and write out 1 potassium and 1 phosphorus on the product side over here. And let's bring back our periodic table. Don't do this without having your periodic table handy. That's really going to help. And so here's our potassium over here in column 1. Those all have a +1 charge. Phosphorus in the same column as nitrogen here, it's got a -3 charge. So just a +1 for the potassium and then a -3 for the phosphorus. So that's where our periodic table comes in handy. So this time I just need 1 phosphorus. Again, if we do our little crisscross trick, and 3 potassiums. So the product formula here is going to be K3 and then just our phosphorus for that. And so this one's actually fairly easy to balance. I've got 4 phosphorus right here, only 1 on the product side on this side. And so I'm going to put a 4 out in front of that. And then 4 times 3 is 12 potassiums. And so we just need to put a 12 out in front of the potassium there. And that equation's balanced. All right. And so that's how we balance metal-nonmetal combination or synthesis reactions.